You ready, Paul?
100% yes.
But yeah, the lightning and all that stuff. So considering all the thunderstorms that we've had and the rain and all that, hey, it's a perfect day to do it. Just as long as the power don't drop out again.
Yes, again.
Again. That's the first time it's happened. Pretty sure.
Yeah, that's first power surplus charge.
Power surge.
Whatever.
Power surplus.
Yeah.
You'd almost think we hadn't been working on this for like 30 minutes.
No kidding.
I don't know. It's good. Show prep is key.
I feel like Stuart's just doing the drops live now.
Lucky.
The fact that she would just judge me immediately.
He's a pretty good ventriloquist.
Did I tell you where this came from? One night we were doing some prep and trying to look at some camera angles, and we figured that we'd try to do just a run through, and he was just obliterated. So I was like, yeah, so what do you think? And he's just sitting there like,
yeah, I'm fucking really drunk, so.
So, of course, I had to go in and chop it up and load it in.
Right.
But it also, it helps you out. I mean, now you kind of realize there's a good way to drink and probably not the best way because you know your brother's going to exploit it.
Yeah, no, I've always apparently...
Stuart fucking commits. He goes hard, Austin. Non-committal motherfucker. Don't like to put labels on things.
No, not really. Well, I mean, that's what label maker's for. Not for relationships. Yeah. But anyways, don't even. But anyways.
I wasn't doing anything. I was breathing heavily.
That's true. It is kind of nice that we don't have the rain, though. We started having like foundation issues and all sorts of crazy stuff.
I
like
the rain.
I love the rain. Don't get me wrong. I just also like a functioning front door.
Oh, I didn't know we had Shirley Manson from Garbage as our guest this evening, Logan.
Shirley
Manson. God, he's not fucking old enough to even know that fucking song. Jesus.
That's
Garbage had a hit song called "It's Only Happy." She's only happy when it rains.
Oh, I don't care.
There are other songs.
It was probably Garbage.
Ah.
Good one, Dad. Thanks.
Point for Logan. The rain. It's just I love it. I just don't like the critters coming out. I saw this article talking about how now you have animals. Snake bites are increasing. Now, if anyone knows me, I'm deathly terrified of snakes.
Oh, actually, there was fabulous interaction the other day. I was in the car with Mom and Dad, and we were about to leave to go to the gym, and Mom's pulling out of the driveway, and she screams, "Snake!"
Are you serious?
Yeah.
What kind of snake was it?
It was, she was under the impression it was a rattlesnake.
Oh, nope.
Oh, I'm sure.
Nope, we ain't going there.
It was a baby rattlesnake.
Where was this?
3 minutes in, we haven't worn the board out yet.
So naturally, I was like, oh yeah, I'm going to take care of this. So I ran in the garage, and I just...
Did you see it?
I hid.
Yeah, so you didn't see it was actual...
Right? Oh, no, I saw it. Yeah. It was a baby. It was, yeah.
Oh, it was a baby. Are you aware that babies have more venom than any adult rattlesnake? No, I don't like that at all.
Yeah, it was terrible.
Apparently, they don't bite you, though, because they don't have the...
They can't control their venom.
They don't have teeth yet.
Though. No, they have fangs. It's not like baby rattlesnakes are born without teeth. They have fangs.
Baby teeth.
But they can't control the venom.
I thought that was the paradox.
Like they get a little too excited?
Yeah, well, they
maybe
can't...
things happen a little too quickly, maybe a little faster than they'd like, embarrassing situation.
Paul, are we talking about an embarrassing situation in the bedroom that you've had, or...?
No, Stuart, we're not.
They can't control their venom.
I was segueing into you, Stuart, I'm sorry.
I don't know what that means.
So therefore, same thing for like a baby brown recluse. That venom is so toxic, most adults have this way of how they know how just enough to put into their predator, or their animal, whatever they're trying to eat, or
is that why
whatever.
There's so much teen pregnancy?
Excuse me?
I don't know if that has to do with Brown Recluse or the Bill Nye Science Guy Power Hour.
Because they never know how much they should put in to the...
How much do you like to put in, Stuart?
I only put in the minimum effort at any given point.
I just put in enough to get the job done.
There you go.
All right.
Be great adult snakes.
And that's why you have two kids.
That's fair. That is true. He wanted those kids, though. We've had...
Eventually.
You did.
Eventually.
He didn't want those
kids.
The
universe wanted those kids. Paul just had to Sometimes bear the brunt of that one.
Sometimes you're a player in that. I mean, you're just a pawn, and you just kind of have to go along with it. The universe gets what the universe wants. It's like life will find a way. I really hate the fact that you told me that story. My bike's still over there. I ain't going back over there.
Yeah, you probably shouldn't. Because that was the baby. Where's mommy?
No, exactly. Yeah. And down in that creek,
yeah.
There's
all sorts. Oh, no, probably coiled up in the chain on the bike, I would bet. Like camouflaged in. Maybe wrapped around the pedals and the spokes. I mean, I don't know.
He's never gonna ride his bike again now.
Oh, no!
So much for exercise.
Nope. I'm just going to get fat. I'm just going to get fat and be on watch for snakes.
Mission accomplished.
Well, you're afraid of spiders.
I hate spiders.
Are you deathly afraid of them?
Yes.
Okay, then F you, because that this is the same thing. At least rattlesnakes, I know I'm not going to wake up and there's a potential rattlesnake in my room. Whereas you
You say that now. On camera, on a live stream.
Yeah, you do live with assholes. So
where are they going to go get... Can you imagine
Mom and Dad trying to...
Could you imagine Stu trying to pull that bit? All right, I'm going to go get a rattlesnake.
There's a crick.
It's all right. The baby rattlesnake don't have teeth. I'll be fine.
I thought that was the dichotomy was, or the...
no.
Have fun explaining that to your insurance. How did you lose your leg? Well, baby rattlesnakes don't have teeth. Dumbass.
I feel like poor science education is a valid excuse for an insurance claim. The state budget was cut for science. We were focusing on abstinence-only education.
Bill Nye the Science Guy is on Netflix now, so...
Is he really?
Yep. So there's no reason not to
know there's no reason not to have any scientific background whatsoever.
Good.
People should get off their asses and take some initiative.
I agree.
Well, by sitting down and watching YouTube.
Well, whatever.
Netflix.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Ignorant slut.
Whoa. Calm down. We're just going to woosaw here for a second.
To be fair, I did watch Netflix while I was on my exercise bike yesterday.
Wait a second.
Yeah?
You own an exercise bike?
I do. I absolutely do. I did 35 minutes. I did 10 miles on the exercise bike. No joke.
I did 30 seconds.
35 minutes. Motherfucker. No joke, though. When I got off the bike, I was numb from the end of my balls to the tip of my
dick. Stu, we're using a wide shot right there, right?
I thought I was done.
We're using a wide shot here?
This is not a fish lens. That's for sure.
You sound like a postmenopausal woman, Paul.
I look like one, too. The transition is almost complete.
I can't.
Once the beard fills out...
I gotta get some audio.
I'm gonna be on...
I gotta get some audio on him and the bike.
I'm gonna be on next month's Vanity Fair.
There you go.
Yeah.
Look at you.
It's gonna...
Right there next to Caitlin.
No.
Caitlin.
No. Don't you dare. I actually pulled the story up.
Oh, did you?
I did.
Oh, fabulous.
Have you heard about this?
No, that's why I didn't just make a joke about it like 15 seconds ago.
I never know with you, Paul.
I
never know with
you.
No,
I just already have Vanity Fair, and then the thing came when I checked the mail
You're
today.
You're so god
from
funny,
fucking
Paul.
Pony Express. God damn it, Austin.
I work with a gentleman who he's 55, and this is...
Does he want a vagina?
No, this has tore him up, though. I mean, he grew up... His father was talking about Bruce Jenner. You might be too young for this, but... He was an incredible athlete, Olympian, all sorts of great feats. And
decathlon.
Was it decathlon?
Yes.
No,
decathlon. An incredible athlete.
That champion of the world.
And again, this is also
10 events, by the way. Decathlon,
yes.
10 events.
Look, this is also a 55-year-old African-American.
Yes, look at you, Stuart. Yeah. On point.
Yeah. Who's a misogynist as well. So you can imagine how tore up he is that you've got the epitome of what a man it was supposed to be.
Can
and
you imagine
now
how the poor guy
Caitlin.
That finished to like silver medal to Bruce Jenner feels right now? Has anybody like checked in to see how he feels about this situation?
I bet he wouldn't feel too bad. I wouldn't.
Well, first of all, silver medal is the first loser.
That is true.
And
what's
then,
the bronze?
And then, the decathlon is the event for the best athlete in the world.
Are you explaining what the decathlon is?
Yes. In the Olympics, the decathlon...
It's called the decathlete?
Well, the person that does the decathlon is the decathlete,
oh, okay.
I suppose. I just remember that because we used to call
I love
the
this
people
show.
That did the math.
I get to learn something mathletes, every time.
So I assume that they're decathletes. I don't really know. But so the decathlon is the competition for the best athletes, the best all-around athlete in the world. And then to finish second, I'm sure is probably disappointing enough as it is. Nice. You know, you trained your whole life for that, and you go to the Olympics and all the pageantry that goes along with that, and, you know, to finish second place in all of the world with all of the world watching is probably, you know, I'm sure he's very happy to have the silver medal, but maybe, you know, still frustrated that he didn't quite get the gold medal. And then to find out that the guy that you lost it to now has a pair of breasts. It might, you know, just, it might just twist the knife a little bit.
Not just a pair of breasts.
Well, yes. So the guy that beat you for the gold medal not only has a pair of breasts, but he looks better looking than his ex-wife does.
His ex-wife is pretty fucking heinous. I'm not going to lie.
All right, I got to read it to you.
But
world,
dudes meet age better than
Caitlyn
women.
Jenner. Caitlyn, formerly known as Bruce Jenner, graces the July cover of Vanity Fair. And she looks amazing. I'm about to mute your microphone right now.
I'm sorry.
I've been told that I curse too much, so I have to.
I'm looking at our social
you
have media.
You just want to rub your fucking fingers off with that fucking board.
I just got called an ugly motherfucker.
Yeah, someone just said, Stu, you were one ugly motherfucker.
That really hurts my fucking feelings.
Y'all's mom is watching this stream.
I love this show. let's see here.
Hi, Susie.
Brian.
I don't know if you're on first name basis with my mom yet there, Paul.
Susie. I don't think I should finish that comment.
I don't think I've ever heard anybody call my mom Susie before either.
So apparently...
Well, we'll show you that live stream later, Stu.
So apparently this just came out. I guess it was on the Vogue cover. Photographer Annie Leibovitz, the woman behind the Kim Kardashian Kanye West Vogue cover, shot the first portraits of Caitlyn earlier this month at her Malibu home. Quote, if I was lying on my deathbed and I had kept this secret and never did anything about it, I would be lying. They're saying, you just blew your entire life. Jenner, who's now 65, tells the magazine. I was probably at the Olympic Games. I was running away from a lot of things. Very, very proud of the accomplishment. I don't want to diminish that accomplishment. The last few days of doing the shoot was about my life and who I am as a person. It's not about the fanfare. It's not about people cheering in the stadium. It's not about going down the street and everybody giving me a that a boy Bruce pat on the back. This is about your life.
I feel like that a boy would be disrespectful at this point.
Bruce always had to tell a lie. He was always living that lie every day. He always had a secret from morning till night. Caitlyn doesn't have any secrets. As soon as the Vanity Fair cover comes out, I'm free. Good for her.
How do we feel about that?
I feel happy that Caitlyn is free and doesn't have any secrets.
I'm happy for her too. I mean...
I just don't give one flying fuck.
Okay. So, I guess,
have y'all ever ventured into that part of your psyche, like to a point where you thought that you should have actually been a woman?
Well, think about if you're stuck in a really crappy job and you hate being there all the time. But
I don't think Bruce Jenner's job.
I'm just throwing a hypothetical out there as a metaphor.
Caitlyn, rather.
I've never been like standing in my kitchen being like, God damn it, I can't figure out what I want for lunch right now. Should I make a sandwich? Should I reheat some? God damn it, maybe I was really born a woman. Fuck, these questions have just brought up too much inside of me.
You see, I'm in definite agreements with you. I don't make enough decisions in my life in order for me to really think, you know what? I'm really questioning this one part of myself. It's just about, okay, what am I going to eat today? Okay, yes. Where am I going to jerk off today?
Oh my God.
Really?
That's
where?
Wow, where?
I feel like
really, where? Austin?
We're not going. Hey.
The seat is still warm.
Just because the studio has good sound quality, Austin, doesn't mean that it's fucking fair game.
During Caitlyn's first day of recovery, she experienced a panic attack for the first time in 65 years. It only lasted 15 seconds. But as she paced around...
what?
Well, if you were listening and not... being nasty.
Apparently there was some pacing.
Oh, okay. So
she,
pacing lasted for 15
she had herself a panic attack for 15 seconds. She would ask herself, what did I just do? What did I just do to myself? A counselor from the Los Angeles Gender Center came over to help ease her mind. Caitlyn explains that since that initial incident, she has not had another, nor does she have any regrets.
Wait, she had a panic attack about her turning into a woman?
Well, I guess, doing the whole physical transformation.
Did she have her penis taken off? It's really hard to say this about a woman. To be like,
yeah,
did she have her penis taken off?
Well, I think a woman if you're going to be a man that's going to go into the transgender, yes, I think. Oh, I'm not trying to be crude.
I like how we're giving this a hypothetical that there's an actual point.
There is a Stuart. There is a procedure.
If I am ready.
There's a procedure as well.
There's a procedure.
Yeah, you're going to have to sew some stuff up afterwards.
Yeah, exactly. Lots of sutures. So, I mean,
Jesus
hey.
Christ.
Good pro form. Sutures. Pro sutures.
Good form.
An anonymous commenter says, enough with Bruce Jenner. Let's talk about all the marine blank Stu used to put in his mouth.
Oh, that's not... That's
oh,
not,
I think that's...
Hold on. That's not an anonymous commenter. That's not an anonymous commenter. That is my buddy Jordan from the Marine Corps.
Is he the blank that needs to be filled in that you had too much of your mouth in the Marines?
I no comment yeah, on that.
Oh my god. Drunk on marine dick, apparently.
I mean, we can talk about that.
That was never a thing.
That sounds like a garbage song.
I mean, we can...
We're going to go back there.
Jordan.
You weren't even alive.
Fuck you, buddy.
That was pretty concise.
I do have a really dark story.
Ooh.
I was going through earlier and... You know, James Holmes, he's making the news again.
I don't know who that is.
You don't know who James Holmes is?
I think he was Sherlock's brother.
No, it was not Sherlock's brother. He was the guy that did the Aurora Colorado
shooting.
Caitlin
with an I or a Y. Oh, right.
Say that again.
Caitlin with an I or a Y?
Aurora. What?
Is it Caitlin with an I or a Y?
I think it's an E.
Y.
What?
It's a Y.
Yeah,
it's a Y. There's been new videos with Mr. Holmes' psychiatric evaluation. Now that he's in prison, they're still trying to get.
Oh, is that the guy that had the orange hair or whatever?
Yeah,
oh,
that's
yeah.
exactly it.
I think John Holmes was the porn star.
Thank you, Stuart. There have been his notebooks came out. I think they talked about he sent a notebook to his psychiatrist, so the one that he was seeing or psychologist before he did the shooting, and they kind of used that as evidence and whatnot. So now they have finally released it to the public. And it's just some really fascinating stuff. I mean,
I think he said that he was sorry that he shot a kid.
Yes.
But he wasn't really sorry for the adults that he murdered.
No, he says, I was worth 12 more people than I was before. When asked, did the wounded count? He responded, I only count fatalities. Holmes also tells a psychiatrist he tried to limit the number of children killed by carrying out the attack at a late showing of a PG-13 movie. The exchange came from Reed's court-ordered sanity evaluation of Holmes conducted last year. Holmes was pleaded not guilty by reason of insanity to the July I did that for you rampage at suburban Denver movie theater. Holmes said he knew his planned attack was legally wrong and referred to it as a crime. He made similar statements on segments played last week. Anything that they would have pursued gets canceled out and given to me, he says. So apparently, it's almost like he's living in a video game where he thinks that he's earning credits.
We all know he's getting the death penalty, right? There's nobody.
I don't know. He's playing the insanity card perfectly right now.
Yeah.
I feel like you can't play the insanity card perfectly. I feel like that's,
that's a little premeditated.
He's pretty good.
Like, oh, I don't know. I sent in my crazy journal to my therapist before I killed everybody.
That's because I was crazy. No matter
only
the
a crazy person would send in the journal talking about your crazy thoughts before you killed somebody. You're gonna have to lock me up, but not kill me. Yeah. It'll be fine.
Sure.
Just give me a Xanax, kids. I'm harmless. I don't feel like that's probably how that's gonna.
I don't know. That begs the question of if you were put in that situation, if you were say you murdered a bunch of people.
Is this the thought you have often, Stuart?
I'm not saying that I think about murdering people often. I'm saying that say that you have murdered some people and you got caught for it. Would you rather be put in solitary your whole life, or would you rather get the death penalty?
Well, I wouldn't want solitary in Colorado, that's for sure. You know those prisons are because they have beautiful scenery like the Rocky Mountains and all that stuff.
That's all you know about Colorado.
Well, no, not at all.
Well, apparently marijuana's legal there, I've heard. I don't know if anybody
that
else
is, that's a good point.
Has
I'm glad you pick up a newspaper.
They set up
I can't
their
even
prisons.
Read.
The architecture is designed to where it's just nothing but the sky. You can't see the mountains and you can't see all that stuff. I mean, it is barbaric.
Oh my.
You get there, you don't see all the nice little pretty things and whatnot. You are by yourself in solitary.
So it's like a Japanese work desk.
What? You mean you're by yourself when you're in solitary confinement?
Well, they're obviously, they pull you out and you do sports and you...
Some activity. You get like a sports in prison.
Well, you get like a basketball. It's kind of
they get a basketball.
Yeah, they give you a choice, and it's you know what's even messed up.
That constitutes
it's
a
not
lot
like
of
a regular court. Whereas
there's
like you'd
one
see,
basketball. There's 7,000 prisoners. We have one basketball.
A lot of sports, Paul.
I stand corrected.
You can play Foursquare with a basketball.
They gave you a choice.
I don't
of
even know what that means.
A basketball.
Can you play it with 7,000 people? It'll take a really long time before it's your
turn. Sounds like a really
cool. No baseball bats.
I feel like all of the prison population of Colorado is like pot smokers and jaywalkers.
No.
It's like the most laid-back prison, man. We're just here like serving out our sentence, man. It's just like what the universe wanted from us, man. We're just having some time to meditate. Three hots and a cot, bro. It's fine.
Say three hots and a cot.
Yeah, man.
That sounds pretty cool, actually.
Why does that sound cool?
It sounds like summer camp for me.
In prison.
Well, not while well, you're not making it sound
well,
like
I mean, then there's the gang rape and all that stuff. First but I mean, all, that's...
Yeah, that's besides the point. It's not a big deal.
I think studies have shown that most anal sex in prison is consensual, so...
Is it really?
Oh, yeah.
So you would be well at home there, is what you're saying.
I don't know. I wasn't in the Marines, Stuart.
That shut him up real fast.
Yeah, sure did. Sure did.
Now, I'll tell you, Marines are some of the gayest dudes I've ever met in my life.
There is
Please tell us more stories, Stuart.
Well, no, I mean, they're some of the straightest gay dudes that you'll ever meet in your life.
At Jordan Terry.
Yeah, at Jordan Terry for one.
Is that his Twitter handle?
No, it's his.
That's his
Ustream
handle.
So it's not like I'm. It's not like I mean, if everybody wants to spam at Jordan Terry,
if mean, all one watcher wants to spam at Jordan Terry, yeah, have at it.
Yeah, go ahead and let it be known that
tons of sports, so many sports, so many listeners,
all the sports.
Stu is right though. There is a lot of homoeroticism in the Marines.
Have
you ever seen the movie Jarhead? You don't watch movies, but have
Paul
you seen...
Paul doesn't watch movies. He doesn't know
what you've seen.
One
the movie
was
Jarhead.
Right? No.
It's who's that? Jake Gyllenhaal?
Yeah.
Jake Gyllenhaal.
Is that the one where he was the sniper?
No. Was he a sniper?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Saw that one.
Yeah.
Fuck you guys.
Yeah. So when they're playing...
It had what's-his-face? Sarsgaard in it.
Yeah.
Sarsgaard?
Peter Sarsgaard. That's his fucking name.
See, whenever you say...
I saw the fuck out of that movie.
See, whenever
fuck
you say
you
Sarsgaard, it makes me sound like an anti-Asian.
There's
sorry, you're a racist.
There's also Jamie
and
Fox.
A bigot.
Because SARS was a disease.
Yes, I remember. And they actually made a funny commercial about it on Saturday Night
and
Live.
And if you're guarding it, then you're against it.
What? What is he talking about?
My thought process.
He's rambling now.
This SARS. Just in, Jordan Terry says, I have so many stories with like 8 exclamation points. Do tell us, Jordan Terry.
No,
do tell us.
Well,
I need explicit details, Jordan Terry.
We'll have to save.
Maybe not so explicit.
We'll have to save those whenever we give him a call someday.
Does anybody have a working phone here, Austin?
Oh, oh my god.
Oh man.
I can't say that.
Sure you can.
Oh god, please do.
Oh please.
Oh god, it's only gay if you. It's only gay if you come, is...
oh, wow.
Is what Jordan Terry says.
But, I mean, isn't that absolutely true, though?
No, not at all. Not at all, Stuart. Not at all.
Negative.
That's what every closeted, straight, married man thinks.
Stu's gonna
then
be...
Then I was told wrongly.
Well, Stu's gonna...
Can we ask Logan how many straight... Mary's men he's done stuff with, or is that a no-go? Is that off limits?
It's not a, I haven't done anything. It's just common knowledge in the culture. In the culture.
Say culture one more time.
Culture.
Culture.
It's in the culture.
Are we talking about yogurt yet?
Wow.
See, and then he has to bring
wait,
that
who likes it Greek?
Gay shit in here.
That's a good question.
Really, Paul?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You wouldn't know anything about Greek yogurt.
I wasn't talking about yogurt.
You're gross, Paul.
What were you talking about, Paul?
You need Jesus, Paul.
Sometimes
That's a great teaser, Logan, because there was someone that actually did need... Well, someone that...
we are going to
I'm
going
to have to throw the teaser out real quick.
All right.
Well, we do have a story.
Is this my surprise?
This is your surprise. I'm going to tease it, though. There was a Florida couple that...
Did they need Jesus?
They got them... Well, they met Jesus behind a KFC, and they got themselves into some trouble.
And on that note, we are going to take a quick intermission, and we will be back.
All righty.
Fuck you.